morning, Saugus. I'm Sabrina Tharastafanian, and today is Monday, November 15th. This is SNN. To celebrate Native American Heritage Month, we thought we'd tell you what the oldest indigenous American tribe is. As with other facts, the period of a time of a tribe has existed for largely depends on the region it came into existence in. Some existed long before Common Era, such as the Olmecs of Mexico, which came into existence in the 1600 BCE. More well-known tribes didn't start coming into existence until the early thousands AD, such as the Navajo, a tribe established around 1300. While no longer existing today, the oldest indigenous American tribe is believed to be the Cloves Society, established as far back as 13,000 BCE. Please stand for the flag salute.
Please stand. Put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated.
Seniors, with less than 20 days left in the fall semester, the deadline to contact your counselor to request a letter of recommendation for four-year universities is approaching. If you need a letter before January 14th, you must contact your counselor by December 11th. If you can contact them before then, please do so. Congratulations to our theater program for winning first place with Puffs in large group comedy, first place with Evita in large group musical, and third place with The Insanity of Mary Gerdard in large group drama in the Drama Teachers Association of Southern California Annual Theater Competition, also known as DTACE. 80 schools from all over Southern California competed, including LA Schools of the Arts, Arcadia, Beverly Hills, and all the Hart school districts, and our theater program took top honors. They also placed first in small groups, same scene, and fourth in our freshman musical, The Little Mermaid. We are so proud of all of their hard work and for making Saugus proud. Throughout November, the Serenity Space will be open from 7:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m., except during in lunch. They will also be hosting weekly events during lunch in room E522. To make an appointment, scan the QR code posted around campus. Now let's go to Shanine Gavorgas with this week's ASB Minute.
Thanks, Sabrina. Good morning, Saugus. I'm Shanine Gavorgas with this week's ASB Minute. Starting off, this Friday is anything but a backpack day. Bring anything other than a backpack. Sadie Hawkins will take place this Saturday from 7 to 11 p.m. Speaking of Sadie's, this is the last week of ticket sales, which can be purchased for $40 with an ASB card and $45 without. If purchased at the door, the tickets will be priced at $50. Want to ask someone to Sadie's? A poster with a Sadie's proposal can be made for you. For a poster, fill out the form located in the ASB office and pay the $5 fee. You'll be contacted to pick up your poster as soon as it is ready. That's all from me. Now let's go to Sophia Card with today's Saugus Sports Update.
Thanks, Shanine. Good morning, Saugus. I'm Sophia Card with your sports news. Congrats to Cheer for winning all three of their competitions this past weekend. We're proud of your accomplishments. Another congrats goes out to Varsity Softball for beating Varsity Baseball 5-4 in a scrimmage last Thursday. Maria Provencino and Alyssa Ramirez had a combined 11 strikeouts, while Trevor Dockery only allowed 5 hits while he was in the circle. Meanwhile, on deck, friend of the show, Joey Cordola, hit a solo home run to deep center field, while Mia Wilson hit 2-2 home runs, one of which sealed the deal for the Lady Sens in the final inning. Congrats again. Today, girls JV and varsity soccer play against Burbank High. Varsity plays at 3 and JV plays at 4:45. Also today, girls basketball plays Westlake High at Westlake. JV plays at 3. Boys basketball plays Providence High at Providence. Varsity plays at 5. The varsity basketball team is looking for a team manager. you will need to travel with the basketball team and must have some basketball experience. Some of the duties also include helping out during practices, filming games, and recording stats. If you're interested, contact Mr. Lapata at glapata@heartdistrict.org. That's all for me. With the end of the first semester approaching, it's important that we reflect on the many difficulties we've faced leading up to this point. Here's more.
The hardest part about not being on campus was not being on campus.
By August of 2020, it was really challenging to have to start fresh online and not have relationships with students and to have to form those over Zoom or Google Meets.
But the campus is like a ghost town without kids around, you know, so it was very, very hard to come to work every day because the smiles, the laughs, the highs weren't there.
It was difficult. I tried to have our classes on Zoom have a lot of socializing in them because I know like it's hard for the academic periods to get that in. So I just wanted space and time for everyone to be able to like kind of talk and hang out as much as possible. So we did like movie nights sometimes. We watched movies on Zoom and yeah, we did our best, but it just takes so long. Yeah.
I think for high school students, learning this way is just not ideal. And so it broke my heart.
The most exciting thing is just being here. Every day I'm just like, yes, like we're here, we're making music. They sound so great. It's so much fun. I'm so glad to be like operating as normal. It's really nice.
Just seeing my kids, they become my kids when they enter my classroom, and meeting them, creating relationships, finding out about them, hearing their terrible jokes, and just making Saugus community, what we are.
Even first day of school, I had the students, all of my classes, interact, I asked a question, they had to write it down and then share it. And just that noise, that verbal noise of meeting people and interacting. And I was getting students that I just met, like people were telling me that they hadn't made friends all last year because, you know, on Zoom or Google Meet, it's very awkward. You don't unmute yourself and say, "Hi, I'm the third box over on the right. Who are you?" Nobody's talking to each other that way. So it was like a refreshing kind of new thing that kind of they were appreciative of. And I loved it. So it's the energy is great. I'm excited.
It's nice to see them grow from freshmen to seniors, mature, which I doubt the freshman class may do, but maybe they will. But I just have a lot of fun with the highs and the calling me by name, by grandpa. I enjoy that, or Tom, or whatever. They show a lot of respect that way. So just enjoy the youth. Makes me feel young. But then I go home and look in the mirror and I'm old. I don't understand.
So the dynamics of the social environment to me is just so outstanding as a teacher too, because I think most teachers have a sixth sense of how is this lesson going? Where is the mental health of the students? And it's not just by asking them. You can see by the way they walk in the room, how they're sitting. You can tell by the tone of voice or their body language, their eye rolls, are their heads down. And when they're on Zoom, you can't do that and you can't reach out and help kids. So we're closer to normality, but we also have that human touch that I think you just can't have online.
Cherish these moments, Saugus. Even though we may be wearing masks, we're back to face-to-face learning, and that counts for something. Good morning, Saugus. I'm Matt Hollenbaugh with the second half of today's show. Saugus Reach is hosting guest speakers in Ms. Hillstein's room, Q1715, on Friday. They'll be virtually hosting their final session of the year with a representative from Concordia University during period 3. Seniors, SNN needs your pictures from your childhood to high school, sports, class life, extracurricular activities, vacations, anything you think marks a great memory you had throughout your life. Send your submission to our Instagram page over direct message or email them to senior22slideshow@gmail.com. That's all for today. I'm Matt Hollenbaugh. Stay tuned for SNN Radio and Saugus Today. Have a great day, and we will see you tomorrow.